Hi there, I'm Liana Tomescu and I'm a Program Manager in Microsoft in the Azure Customer Experience Engineering team. I am focused on Azure Security Center and today I'm here to give you a quick overview of the security control called Encrypt Data in Transit, which is a critical security control part of Azure Security Center. So let's see how it works.
So here I am in Security Center, in the Recommendations pane. So at the top here, we can see that the secure score is only 39%, which means that we have the opportunity to secure it by a further 61% or 36 points. Our goal is to get the secure score to be at 100%, because remember, the higher the secure score, the higher your security posture. So today we are going to be focusing on one of the security controls that will help us to increase our secure score. That is Encrypt Data in Transit. So if we follow the recommendations underneath this security control, then we have the opportunity to get a maximum of 4 points added to our secure score. We can see our current score, we can see the potential score increase, we can even see the unhealthy resources, how many there are. And if we are to look at the recommendations underneath, we can see that there are several of them. The main thing to note is that the recommendations that have this symbol but beside them, they're actually recommendations that are in private preview, which as the note says, this means that this recommendation won't affect your secure score until the recommendation goes to GA, which is general availability. We can see here that we have one of four web applications which are unhealthy for this particular recommendation. So we'll click it. So this is web application should only be accessible over HTTPS. Okay, so if we see this page, we can see that we have several options here at the top. Exempt basically allows us to exempt a particular scope, such as a management group or subscription or a resource, from being applicable for this recommendation. So this recommendation, once it's exempted from this particular scope, such as from this subscription, then it will not show up for this subscription. It will actually appear in the not applicable resource. And once we do exempt this particular recommendation, you do have to bear in mind that it is part of several regulatory compliance standards, such as these three listed below. And once you exempt it, the exemption will be created on all of these standards. Okay, and the way to do the exemption is by giving it a name. You can also set an expiration date. You need to give it an exemption category. And this just explains why it's exempted. And the first option is mitigated, which means that this recommendation is actually already resolved through a different way outside of Azure Security Center. And the other option is waiver, which means that we are going to accept the risk of this. We do not want to have to worry about this particular recommendation for the scope that we have selected above. We give it a description, we press create, and the exemption has been created, will be created. So, next up, we can also view the policy definition. So you can remember that you should take note of the fact that each recommendation actually has its own policy definition that comes from Azure Policy. And here you can see it, you can make changes to it, you can assign it, duplicate it, and so on. We can also create a query for this recommendation. We can directly open a query that will bring us to the Azure Resource Graph Explorer page. Here, we can create a new query, or we can start off by using one of the example queries that we have underneath. Okay, so what else can we find out about this particular recommendation of web applications should only be accessible over HTTPS? Well, we can get the description of it. We can find out which resources are affected. And here we can see the unhealthy resources, which means that we need to make some changes so that this web application will only be accessible over HTTPS. We can also see the healthy resources, so those resources for which this recommendation has already been remediated. And we can see not applicable resources, which, as I've mentioned previously, shows the resources that have the exemption on them. Okay, so how can we actually remediate this unhealthy resource here? There are two ways. And the really simple and quick way is through the quick fix. So this particular recommendation has a quick fix, which is brilliant. This means that it's incredibly easy to make the change to remediate it. And the way to do that is simply by clicking on the resource that you want to remediate. In this case, I've clicked on this, and then you click on fix. Once you do that, this pane appears, which gives you more information. And if you click fix this one resource, then it will be instantly, it will be fixed. However, I am going to demo the other way that we can remediate this particular resource for with this recommendation, and that is the manual way. The manual way is actually not as difficult as it sounds. We are going to go to this particular place, and here we can see that we have been brought to the exact app service that we are looking to remediate. And we are already being brought into the customs domain pane under the settings, which is where we're looking to go. Here we can see the customs domain, and here we can see the option of HTTPS only. It's currently set to off. We simply update it there, and it means that it has been successfully set to on. After a few minutes, this resource will now appear in the healthy resources section in this particular recommendation. So whether it's the quick fix way, or if you choose to do it manually by going on this, it's super easy to make the change. We recommend that you look at the rest of them that are in GA, and also do take a look at the others that are in preview, because when they go to GA, if you have not already remediated them, that will affect your secure score. So you want to remediate them as soon as possible, and that's also beneficial for your security posture overall.
That was it. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope it helped you on your journey to improving your security posture with Azure Security Center. So please like this video and subscribe to our channel, and also make sure to subscribe to our Microsoft security community so that you can get all updates about Azure security in your inbox and all of the videos and all of the latest updates. So speak to you again.